thought sports fans had a laugh. And the maestro of some of that hilarity was one Charles Dillon Casey Stengel. According to one story, he was on his way up the home plate one time with a lineup card, tipped his hat, and let a bird fly out. In another one, when he got that first Met team together, he said, "Gentlemen, I think we better start at the beginning. This is a baseball. Never let it out of your sight."
Good advice, but easier said than done, because sometimes the ball has a habit of getting lost. In the last World Series, Oriole third baseman Doug DeSensei lost this Baltimore chop in the lights of Baltimore's Memorial Stadium. But you have to take your hat off to Chicago's Larry Bittner. He did, and lost the ball in it.
If I remember correctly, it was a low line drive, and I came running in, and of course it was one of those plays where he didn't know if he could get to it or not, and so I just dove for it, and I caught it, and as I hit the ground, I guess, you know, I saw it later on replays and that as I hit the ground, my glove kind of opened up and the ball just kind of trickled out of it, and of course I have kind of notorious that my hat falls off every time I run, whether, you know, being running the bases with my helmet or in the outfield or wherever, but so I'm kind of, you know, I'm sitting there and I can't feel the ball, you know, I know I caught it, and then when I got up and looked at my glove, of course I couldn't feel it, you know, come out, and I looked at my glove and it wasn't there, and then I started looking around for it and I couldn't find it, and I kind of panicked. I said, "My God, where's that ball at?" Because, you know, I looked everywhere. I even looked straight up in the air thinking it was still in the sky somewhere, but finally, you know, it just kind of dawned on me to look under my hat, and I flipped it over and there it was.
Former Yankee left-hander Steve Hamilton had a pitch that batters could easily lose in the sun. He called it his folly floater. And when one-time Indian Tony Horton popped this big, fat, juicy-looking thing up, he probably wished he could lose himself somewhere. Hamilton didn't discover it. Rip Sewell did, a lot of years before, in the 1946 All-Star Game.
Well, all the sport writers came down on the bench from all the Detroit sport writers and all the Pittsburgh sport writers, and wanted to know what in the world was that pitch. And I said, "Well, I don't name them, I just throw them." Well, the fellow sitting on the bench beside of us was Maurice Van Roboys, an outfielder. You tell us the outfielder, he says, "That's an Ephus ball." The sport writer said, "What's Ephus ball? Now, what is Ephus?" He said, "Well, Ephus ain't nothing. That's what that ball is."
Now, Hamilton and Sewell had funny pitches, but Mark the Bird Fidrich was a very funny pitcher. And boy, could he ever chirp. He'd talk to the ball, he'd talk to the hitters, he'd talk to himself. But that was really his charm. He was like a mascot, and every team seems to need a mascot or a bird. Thank you. happened if almost every team has its mascots? Almost every team lets the kids come out and play dad for a day. That.
Speak softly, love, and hold me warm against your heart. I feel your warmth, the tender trembling moment start. We're in a world, our very own, sharing a love that only few have ever known. Why? Colored days worn by the sun, deep velvet nights when we are one. Speak softly, love, so no one hears us but the sky. The vows of love we make will live until we die. My life is yours.
Now, you know, I never argued with umpires like that. Besides, what's 240 hitter got to beef about? At least that's what the umpires told me.
Mark Twain may have put Calaveras County on the map, but he put the frogs there on the spot. It's the annual jumping contest. While the frogs do just about what comes naturally, watch the people. There's something else. And if frogs do what's natural for them, I guess the same goes for skiers. This is not a Doris Day movie. It's just good, clean American fun. I've heard of Mud Patch, but this is ridiculous. Eat your heart out, Miss Piggy. A question. What do chimney sweeps do on their day off? They play rugby, of course. Great catch, Tommy, but you still owe us a round.
Tommy, that line's getting a little old, and I'm getting a little thirsty, so maybe we ought to wrap this whole thing up. I've enjoyed it tonight, and I hope you have too. But remember, there's a whole lot of wild and crazy moments in sports just looking for a place to happen. And all you have to do is what Casey said. Keep your eye on the ball. I'm Ron Swoboda. So long.